Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yes. For today's class, we'll request four people to unmute the mic. Yesterday, till I think Roshan have given their participation. For today's class, I request Aswatram, Bhavya, Kalyan, Shitesh to join with us. Aswatram, Bhavya, Kalyan, Shitesh. And even 45, Komal is also requested to join with us. Please join Arvind, Ashwatram, Bhavya, Kalyan, Chitash, and Campbell Komal. Okay, shall we start our presentation? Bhavya, please unmute your mic.
Yes, and, sir. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Chitash?
Yes, sir.
Chitash, please. And Ashwatram?
Yes, sir.
Ashwatram? Ashwatram, I think not yet joined. Okay. Okay, shall we start? What was the last class, Bhavya? What was the last class?
Sir, we did the standard 5-point formula and you asked us to do this.
Pardon, what was name of the subject?
Initial value problem.
No, last class. 2 to 250. I'm inquiring about 2 to 250 class. For your class, concerning a who handled the last class. And Rahul?
Yes, sir.
Yes, Rahul. I know who shall we start?
Am I audible, sir?
Yes, of course, Rahul. Shall we start or we will take some more minutes to join? The last class concluded at the right time? Or
Yes, sir. We didn't have a class. We had
okay.
A class at the
okay, for Bhavya it is okay. For Rahul, shall we start, Rahul?
No, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Because 23 people only joined, that's why I am seeking. Any delay in the last hour?
Sir, no, sir.
No.
Okay, fine.
Yet three more have to join, sir. Ashurat, Komal and Monani, that's all.
They are coming, sir. Can we wait for 2 minutes?
Okay, fine. Okay, we'll start today's session. And we have started the unit 4, that is boundary value problem and the initial value problem. Concerning the presentation. What we have introduced yesterday. Okay, the elliptic equation or standard 5-point equation, we are going to find the value of uij based on the four boundaries in the axis, that is Cartesian coordinates. Based on that, we are going to find the results. And this is the diagonal 5-point formula, which is very similar to standard diagonal formula. And this is Laplace equation, and this is Laplace equation, that is u1. We are going to find the values of where is u. U1 to u9 we are going to find based on the boundary values. The boundary values are represented with the aid of a. A1 to a16 are the boundary values. With the aid of a1 to a16, we are going to find the various unknowns of u's. It may be a temperature for temperature or whatever it may be. It, the unknown can be found with the aid of either standard 5-point formula or a diagonal 5-point formula. And this is the formula. And u5, that is center point, can be calculated with the help of this formula. And the diagonal 5-point formula, this u1, u3, u7, u9 can be calculated with the aid of this four formula. Once u1 to u9 is calculated, then we can find the various u2 even number unknowns with the aid of standard 5-point formula. And concerning the formula, that is Lippmann's iteration process, why we need to improve the formula. This is the improved version of Laplace equation. This is Laplace equation. And see the given diagram. If we are in the first iteration, that is zeroth iteration, we are calculated all u to u9. Consider we are calculated various u's. U1 and to u1 till u9 are known. Now we are calculating for the second iteration. We'll start from zeroth, then first iteration. Now concern about the first iteration. In the first iteration, with the aid of standard 5-point formula, we can calculate various u's. Here, concerning the u1, u16, a2, u2, and u4 can be used. Similarly, u2, u3, u4. And what was the u5 can be calculated with the aid of u4 and u2, u6 and u8. For that u5, we are going to adopt the newer calculated u2 values. That is the improved version of Laplace equation. How we did in Gauss-Seidel, the newer iteration formula can be find the other unknowns. That is the improved version of Gauss-Jordan or Gauss-Jacobi. Please remind me whether it is Gauss-Jordan or Gauss-Jacobi. Please anyone, Bhavya, Ashwatram, whether it may be Gauss-Jordan or Gauss-Jacobi. Ashwatram, Bhavya, Campbell, Komal. Okay, since it was a afternoon class, we will discuss the current affair, and we will start the today's presentation. And anyone wish to talk the current affair? With that, I will take Rattan's also. Anyone wish to talk the current affair? In South India, famous singer called SPV, S.D. Balasubramanian, who passes away, who sang more than 40,000 songs in different languages, more than 15 languages. Even he given music for 40, more than 40 number of films. Anyone wishes to, anyone willing to talk about the information about SPB? Are you attending? No one
replied. Yes, sir, we are attending.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes, Nishant given IP. Okay. Okay, give some information about him. In order to wake up your friends. Any singers are in that 35? Among 35, any singers are there? Then we will request him to
post on Instagram.
Then we will request him to make a song. Who is the singer? In R34 and 35, any singers are there?
So Vimalesan sings.
Vimalesan, ah.
Yeah, he posts on Instagram also.
I think his Vimalesan, your mic is now good. It is in working conditions. Vimalesan. For the last lesson, some other people apart from Rahul responded regarding the agriculture issue. My appreciation. And concerning today's class, please give a note about SBB and we'll continue with today's presentation. Please go ahead. Anyone? Rahul? Have you heard about the information about SBB?
No, sir. Like, I'm not aware, sir. Yeah, he's no more. Like, actually, before he was admitted in the hospital, and the fake news came in the newspaper, and the news that he died. Then his son came out, and he told that it was a rumor. And today afternoon, he passed away. That's all I knew, sir.
Yes. And I think, Bhavya, your friend responded our question that you are a singer. That we'll request you to sing once the information is about SBB is over. Then we will sing. And any other person, anyone willing to share about SBB? Probably the South Indian people very well known about SBB. Nishant. You are an active person.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Yes. Have you information related to SBB?
I mean, most of the Rajnikant intros are sung by him.
Many actors, many superstars like Rajini and other leading actors like Kamal in Vijay, Ajit, even in some other languages also. He sung song for the introduction, and please go ahead.
Yeah. I haven't heard, like, I don't remember the names and all, but I've heard most of the songs. Every time you switch on the radio, it's either a song. He sung so many songs with that.
Yes, he sang more than 40,000. In some TV, they are posting that more than 50,000, maybe more than 40,000 songs. Even he sung 21 songs in a day. That was a record. The more number of songs, that is most number of the songs sung by SBB, that is also a Guinness record. And who got 6 national awards, and etc. And I think you're all now waked up. We'll continue the class once Bhavya responded, means we can continue. Bhavya? Bhavya, go ahead.
Yes, sir.
Yes, please sing any song.
Sir, they are pranking, sir. I don't sing, sir. They are pranking.
They are pranking. Okay, fine. Okay, anyway, before concluding new methods, the methods, we request all 35 to give an active participation. If it is in a classroom, then we can, there are plenty of ways to give active participation. Since it was a presentation via MS team, we can get a oral conversation. The participant, you can give your participation through your songs. It may be a prank. We will make it true. Yes, I think Vimalesan given the information that you are a classical singer. Okay, anyway, once Vimalesan, I think for the today's class, he may not be willing, or he may have some disturbance. Soon we will expect him and even others to sing a song during the classes. When it was an afternoon class, when our class is boring, then at that time we will request you to give your presence. Okay, Bhavya, it is good? You are a classical singer?
No, sir, no.
Okay, fine.
I am not a trained singer, sir.
Okay, that your friends only know. Okay, come back to the diagonal 5-point formula. Okay. See, now the what happened in U5? The U5 can be calculated. Is Abhishek? Abhishek, we will discuss Abhishek. Okay, if we wish to find U5, U5 can be calculated with the aid of U2 and U4, which is newly calculated in the recent iterations. Therefore, we can build an advanced version of Laplace, that is nothing but Lippmann's iteration process. That is, the top and left can be un plus 1. The top and left can be un plus 1 rather than the right and bottom portions. This is the Lippmann's iteration process, which is very similar to the Gauss-Jacobi and Gauss-Seidel. Jacobi, we are not fed the information which we derived in the present iteration, but in Gauss-Seidel, we fed the newly derived information in the same iteration. That is what we are going to do with the Lippmann's iteration process. It is a very, very, very easiest way to, it is very easier than the so-called other techniques called the Jacobian Gauss-Seidel. What we have to do, this is the formula we have given yesterday. And we have to build our own diagram. This is a diagram. See the given four boundaries. Here, uxx plus uyy is equal to 0. We need to identify whether it is belongs to the elliptic, parabolic, or hyperbolic. If it is equal to 0, then it is called. Someone, please. Arvind, Ashwatram, uxx plus uyy is equal to 0. No, I am speaking about b square minus 4ac. If the b square minus 4ac is less than 0, that is belongs to elliptic or parabolic?
Elliptic.
If it is less than 0, b square minus 4ac less than 0, that is elliptic. Equal to 0, parabolic. If it is greater than 0, that is hyperbolic. This is d square u by or dou square u by dou x square plus dou square u by dou y square is equal to 0. We have seen this is belongs to an elliptic equation. Please apply those information, that is B, A, C, and then you can find it is belongs to elliptic equation. Elliptic can be solved with the aid of two different methods, that is one is Laplace and the other one is Poisson's equation. If the RHS is 0, then that can be classified as Laplace equation. Here the boundary for the x varies from 0 to 4 and y varies from 0 to 4. And the y of 0 comma y is equal to 0. In x axis y is equal to 0. In y axis x is equal to 0. Therefore, this first boundary condition sharing the information about the leftmost axis. That is 0 comma y is equal to 0. For all y, if y is equal to 1, then that is 0. Then y is equal to 2, that is also 0. y is equal to 3, 0. Y is equal to 4, 0. This is saying the information, sharing the information about the leftmost axis. And concerning the second point, that is u of 4 comma y is equal to 8 plus 2y, and this is the rightmost information, and we can categorize this, or we can divide the given information based on the boundary condition, that is 0 to 4. Therefore 4 plus 4 is, that is 16 square mesh can be divided. This is the way we need to build our own mesh. Here see, y is equal to 0. Apply this y is equal to 0 in 8 plus 2y, we will get 8. And if y is equal to 2, 2 to the 4 plus 8, we'll get, if y is equal to 1, we'll get 10. If y is equal to 2, then we'll get 12. If y is equal to 3, 14. If y is equal to 4, 16. Therefore, right side boundary is also done. Then, concerning about the bottommost horizontal axis, x comma 0 is equal to x square by 2. Apply various x values. Apply 0, 0 square by 2, 0. Then 1 square, 1 by 2, will get 0.5. 2 square by 2, that is 4 by 2, 2. Then 3 square by 2, that is 9 by 2, 4.5. Then 4 square, 16 by 2, you will get 8. Then we need one more boundary also, the upper boundary. The upper boundary is x comma 4 is equal to x square. X comma 4 is equal to x square. And here 0, 0 square is 0, 1 square 1, 2 square is 4, and 3 square 9, and 4 square is 16. And in this way, we need to achieve the various boundaries, outermost boundaries. And importantly here, the h and k is the difference between the axes in x as well as y. The mesh here, the mesh can be taken as one. This we can divide 0 to 4 in many ways. 0 to 4, that way also we can take. 0, 0.5, 1, 1.5, that way also we can take. The distance between the mesh in x-axis can be considered as 1, and the distance between the mesh in the y direction has to be taken as 1. That is based on this h is h and k. H belongs to x and y belongs to k. And obtain the results correct to one decimal places. And this is the way we need to draw our own 16 meshes. And please take your calculator and in that calculator you give 0.25 open bracket a b c d plus a plus b plus c plus d. Take your calculator and give a plus b plus c plus d. 0.25 instead 1 by 4, I have given 0.25. And you know, brackets you give a, b, c, d. Now give c, a, l, c. The calculator will enquire about a. Now we'll find u5 first. Based on standard 5-point formula, we are going to find the u5 first. For u5, the a is 0. 0, here 0. And top give equal to, then your b is equal to 4, then your c is equal to 12, then your d is equal to 2. What is your answer? What is your answer? Kalyan, Chitash? Kalyan,
can you repeat the...
Your A, B, C, D is 0, 4, 12 and 2.
4.5.
Yes, 4.5. Please make a note. With the diagram we need to solve, please make a note. Your U5 is equal to 4.5. You make a note. Then we'll solve, we'll find U1, U3, U5, U7 and U9. U1 can be calculated in two ways. One is standard 5-point formula. We have standard 5-point formula. The other one is diagonal 5-point formula. Concerning U1, I apply standard 5-point formula. Here, we know 0, 1, U2 and U4. In this case, there are two unknowns, U2 and U4 are unknown, but while considering the diagonal 5-point formula, that is 0, 4 and U5, now we have calculated U5 and this way. And while applying standard diagonal 5-point formula, we can find various U in odd numbers. U1, U3, U7 and U9 has to be calculated with the aid of diagonal 5-point formula. Okay. Again, continue with the same CALC in your calculator. A, again, A will n square in A. Instead A, you give 0. Your B is your 4. This is 4. Your C is your U5. That is 4.5. And your D is 0. Then what is U1?
2.125.
Yes. Very, very. Only Bhavya is responding, but please others Kalyan, Chitash, Ashutra, and Komal Campbell, you also join with us, Komal. Now we will calculate Ashutra, Kalyan, Chitash, please respond us.
Yes, sir.
And again, yes. Now try to find your U3, your A is 4. Then B is 16, then C is 12, then your D is 4.5 is your U5, give equal to, then what is your U3?
9.125.
Yes, 9.125. Okay, we will calculate U7. Concerning U7, 0, A is 0, B is 4.5. C is 2, D is 0. What is our U7? 0, 4.5, 2 and 0.
1.625.
Yes, 1.625. Okay. U9, 4.5, 12, 8 and 2. Yes, U9,
6.625.
Yes, 6.625. Okay, well, now we can calculate U2, U4, U6 and U8 based on standard 5-point formula. We are not considering diagonal 5-point formula here. Various four boundaries in the axis are known. Then apply your standard 5-point formula. There may be confusions. There are possibilities for finding the values in both the standard diagonal 5-point formula as well as in standard 5-point formula as well as in diagonal 5-point formula, which is more suited means the standard diagonal standard 5-point formula is more suited rather than the diagonal 5-point formula. Therefore, in order to calculate U2, U4, U6, U6 and U8, apply your standard 5-point formula. Isn't it? Okay. Now calculate your U2, U4, U6 and U8. Nine point four three seven five. Similarly, U4, U6 and U8. Now we did our zeroth iteration, then and concerning your first iteration, we need to apply Lippmann's iteration formula. Lippmann's iteration formula, that is, there is a change in top and left. There is a change in top U and left U. And this is our first iteration. This is our first iteration, U1, U2, U3, U4 and U5. And concerning the U2, the U1 leftmost is known. And concerning this U4 and U11 and U21 are known. And concerning the U5, rather zeroth iteration, we are going to consider the first iteration itself. The first iteration information can be used as an input for finding U5 in iteration 1. That is said to be an Lippmann's iteration formula. Please find various U's, U1, U2, U3, U4 and U5. And this is for your U6, U7, U8 and U9. And this is the way usually we need to start our iteration. But the easiest way to represent the various elliptical equations, whether it may be elliptic, parabolic or hyperbolic, is this is the way you need to represent. This is the way you have to write your solutions. Writing your solution with nearer to you. And once this is the highlighted, that is red color rounded information, is zeroth iteration, and above that is first iteration and second iteration. This is the way you can write your informations. With this you can easily find your results. With a single table itself you can do your all the iterations, then you can find your unknowns. And in connection with the question, they are requesting us to solve with one decimal places, accurate with one decimal places. Therefore, we attained the similarity in third iteration itself. Therefore, I have stopped the iteration there. 9KC 999 and 0.99 KS00660055775. Even that was attained in the zeroth and first iteration itself. The thing is, here we are getting 2.000 and 1.9. Then that won't be one decimal place is equal. Therefore, I am doing the second iteration also. The closeness between first iteration and second iteration are closer with one decimal places. Therefore, I have stopped my iteration with second iteration. Therefore, I request you to solve with this. You draw a very big table for finding the results. And start writing from the U1, very nearer to U1, then your first iteration, then your second iteration. And based on the calculator option, that is 0.25 into ABCD, and the summation of ABCD and the CALC can reduce your entire time, and you can get your results as early. Yes, any doubts in problem number 2? Exercise number 2. Any clarification regarding Laplace or Lippmann's iteration formula? Okay. Once we'll take attendance and then we'll see the problem number 3. Purnachandra is absent. Eight absences. I think it is very hard to attend the afternoon classes. Okay. Number one is present. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Number three is absent. Okay. Number six is also absent. Ashwatram present? Ashwatram is also absent. Kalyan? Kalyan is also absent. Siddhash? Siddhash?
Yes, sir.
Please join with us, Siddhash. Please unmute your mic. Till the end, please unmute.
Okay, sir. It's noisy here, sir. So
if noise is noise, means you mute me.
Okay, sir.
Spotify is also option. Spotify?
Yes, sir.
You are present, but now only you are saying.
My net connectivity is very low, sir, today. So at some time I'm unable to see the PPT also.
Oh, then it is fine. Good. Okay, fine. Okay. Maharajan? Actually. Varshita?
Present, sir. Yeah, present, sir.
Kaushik? Naura Kaushik? Avarni?
Present, sir.
Vikash Babu Mehta? Okay. Number 3, number 6. Number 17, number 24, number 60, 71, and 117 and 121. This is the absent. Any deviations or anyone joined means please let me know, representatives, and we'll see call number 3. Okay, please make a note. Given the values of u, x, y on the boundary of the square given in figure, evaluate your u, x, y satisfying Laplace equation del u square is equal to 0 at the pivoted points of this figure. Okay, this is the figure. In all the time, the figure won't be given in the diagram. At some time, they will give the figures, and this is we are considering. We have to take that various u's, u1, u2, u3, u4. These are the various boundaries. 1000, 1000, 1000, 1000 at the top, and 1500 at the bottom. And similarly, we have RHS and LHS. And this is the Lippmann's iteration formula. In every sum, you need to write the Lippmann's iteration formula, and this is our in first zeroth iteration. See what was the drawback in standard 5-8 formula. There are two unknowns. And concerning the first u1 of 0, we are there is only one unknown, that is u4, Therefore, initially assume u4 is equal to 0. Here no other way. If the unknown are in odd number, if it is u5 or u7 or u9, if it is u9, then we can find the value of standard 5-point formula itself. Then h is equal to 2 and k is equal to for initial iteration. But for the mesh is here, we are having 9 mesh. There is no other way. With the aid of known formula, we cannot find where is u. Therefore, assume your u4 is equal to 0. Therefore, you will get your u1 is equal to 1000. Similarly, you will get u2. Now we found the value of 1000. We can apply 1000, 1500 and u4. Here u4, consider your again u4 is equal to 0. Then your u3. Calculate your U3, 2000, 1000, and then U4, again 0, then 500. And as I said earlier, draw a table like this way, and then try to solve the various boundaries itself. We know with a table itself, and please have your calculator, Kamal Kombal, please solve this problem. Rahul.
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes.
Sir, I have a doubt, sir. No? So why did we assume U4 to be 0?
Yes, yes. Initially, assume your U4 is equal to 0.
So why?
No other way. We cannot find based on the available resources itself. We cannot find the various views. Rahul, please solve and tell me the various results. We will start with the zeroth iteration. Check
okay,
these
are
your results.
Yes.
You are also getting or any deviations. 0.25 into a plus b plus c plus d.
One second, sir.
For U1 alone, we need to apply 1000, and B is also 1000. Your C is 2000, or D is 0. Or along with Rahul Sabrani, you also joined with Rahul Sabrani.
Yes, I'll check.
Yes, please take your calculator and feed, that is 0.25 into a plus b plus c plus d. Please give your CALC and I will disseminate the information. That is a is 1000 and this is your a, that is 1000, and again b is also 1000. Then come to here u4 is equal to 0, and here your D is 2000. And now tell me the result. Varshita, I request all five gentlemen to join with us. That is Bhavya, Campbell Komal, Marikanti Ashwini, Varshita, and Savarnipal. Please take your calculator, please respond us. Still you are calculating, Rahul Sabarni?
1000, sir.
Yes. You are telling
sir,
the answer?
1000, sir. Yes, sir. 1000, sir.
Thousand.
Answers.
Okay, we'll find U2. We will find U2. Please practice with us. Please, I am giving so much time for your practice. Since you are practicing in examination or in your any other way you are practicing it is will be very difficult. We are giving plenty of time for your practice and for your notes making. Please respond us. This time for your practice. Please take your calculator. Shall we calculate Rahul and Sabrani? Shall we calculate you too?
Yes, I am calculating you too, sir.
Okay, I'll tell you. Your A is 1000. Your B is also 1000. Then your C is your 500. D is 0. Now tell me this, sir.
Sir, am I audible? Hello?
Yes, of course. Who is this?
Bhavya, sir.
Bhavya,
so
yes, tell me.
625.
Pardon, Bhavya?
625.
625, yes, of course. 625. Okay. We will calculate the U3. U again equal to, that will inquire about the A. A is from left, we'll move. From left, we'll move to 2000, then 1000. This 1000 is the first iteration. We are in the first iteration. We are given the information in the first iteration. So that is then that is Lippmann's iteration. 1000. Then here U4 is unknown. U4 is unknown 0, and your bottom is 500. And now tell me the result.
875.
Yes, sir. Yes. Now again give equal to.
375.
Yes.
That's
yes. Yes. 875 equal to 625 equal to 0 equal to 0. You will get 375. Okay. Again, go back to your U1. Go back to your U1. 2000, 1000, 625, and 875. You will get. You'll get 1125. You'll get 1125.
Sir, 1125, sir.
Yes, yes. And again, give equal to 1125.
750.
Yes, yes. 1000 and 500 and 370. As I said. As you said, 750 is the answer, and this is the way you need to represent your results. This is the way you need to represent your various results. Once the zone is over, here I am zero to first iteration, second, third, fourth, fifth iteration. My zone is I am not having enough spaces for writing. Here I have written. See, here I have written. Here on the right I have written. On the bottom, this is U3. I have written at the bottom. Here, see, U4 I have written at the bottom. Therefore, with the table itself, we can find various cells. And concerning the solution, our U1 is equal to 101208, U2 is equal to 792, and U3 is equal to 1042, and your U4 is equal to 458. Please solve the problem till your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 iterations. It won't take much time. The calculator itself, with this table itself, we can find. No need to proceed all the steps. But the thing is, during examination, please remember, during examinations, at least write 0th iteration and first iteration. And for your practice, please make a note. This is for your practice. Please make a note.
Sir, the figure.
This is your figure, and this is in the easiest way we can solve this equation. I'll move some more informations that here the given entire figure is symmetric about both the axes. Have you heard about the axisymmetric components? Axisymmetry.
No, sir.
The shaft is in shaft is symmetric or based on the axis. We can revolve based on the axis. The rectangle, by revolving the rectangle, we can get the cylinder. Similarly, you can get your cone also. Here, this is not in that way. This is symmetric about xx as well as yy. Therefore, are all u1, u3, u7, u9 are equal, and u4 and u5 are equal. Then we are going to find only one three values. That is u1, u is yes. Find some information that is. The above given boundary values are symmetric with respect to horizontal and vertical, and it is symmetric. If it is symmetric about xx means U1 and U7 are equal, U2 and U8 are equal, and U3 and U9 are equal. If it is symmetric about YY, mean what happens? U1 is equal to U3, U4 is equal to U6, and U7 is equal to your U9. And therefore, here U1, U3, U7, U9 are equal, and U2, U8 are equal, and U4 is equal to U4. Hence, it is enough to find with only three values, that is U2, U1, U2, U4. And this is your results. Please solve this problem. We'll discuss the results of this particular problem in the next class. That is Monday, we will see. Any doubts or any inputs you needed for solving this problem? Any inputs? The given inputs are enough.
So do we consider U5 to be 0 or we don't?
Zero. You have to find, initially you have to find your U5. First you need to find U5 based on the four different boundaries. That is not zero. Here there is no need to consider zero as an input. If your number of unknown is 4, then there is a need to assume U is equal to 0. And if it is 9, there is no need to assume U is equal to 0, because we can calculate U5. Any other doubts? Right. The thing is, U1, U3, 7, 9 are equal, U2, U8 are equal, U4 and 6 are equal, U5, we have to calculate. Therefore, only in one particular iteration, you are going to calculate four information, that is U5, U4, U6, U2, U8, U1, 3, 7, 9. Anyway, you calculate your results, we will cross-check your results with the information which we have. And we'll meet. If there is no doubt, we can wind up today's class. Okay, thank you, Anuradha.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Yes.